There is no fear in love. Perfect love drives out fear. Whoever lives in love lives in God, for God is love. There is no fear in love. Yes. Hello, everybody. This is Nedu.
And this is Yama Obed.
Obed. Yeah. Welcome to Relationship Forum once again. And we believe relationships should be a blessing and not a nightmare. So we ask you today, are you in a relationship? Or are you planning to get into one? Then you've come to the right place. We discussed issues that will help us make our relationship a blessing. Before we get into the topic of the day, remind you to subscribe to our Love Divine, Relationship Forum. Look for Nedu and Ozioma on YouTube, Love Divine Relationship on YouTube, and you can subscribe to it. All right. And of course, if you're on Facebook, just follow us and you will see more of our topics. Having said that, our topic today is an interesting one, I believe. Yes, and we're going to start by saying that you said that when you get married, you're actually not just marrying the single person, you're marrying the family. Family. So family can be a very important part of marriage.
Marriage, yes.
Okay, so the question is, how is your family impacting your relationship? The title of our discussion today is, now is your family helping or hurting your relationship? Is your family helping or hurting your relationship? That's where we want to go today. So I want to ask you, what do you think about extended family and relationships?
So families are very important in relationships because we all grew out of families.
Yes.
So we need love and care from our families.
Okay.
Because who is an island? Nobody is. No man is an island.
Nope.
You need
nope.
People. You need emotional support of your family. You need you may need physical support from your family, like let's say you have a child that you need babysitting for, and you have maybe your parents, you know, can babysit for you.
They're great people to be because they have love for the child, and
so you need physical support like that. We can also need informational support from our family. This is when, let's say, you are a new parent. There are a lot of things you don't know about child bearing, parenting, that you can get information from your family. Mm-hmm. So you need informational support. You're starting your own family. They've been there. So
you're saying that there are so many good things about acknowledging and embracing your family.
Yes.
Or
yes.
The other person's family.
Exactly.
In relationship.
Exactly.
Okay.
And then you can also need financial support.
Financial support. Especially when you're starting new.
Yes.
This might be one of the reasons some people they don't want to start, because they say, I don't have money yet and stuff. The family can be a help when you're just beginning.
Beginning,
and,
yes.
So you need the family.
So in that way, in those respects, they help. Yeah. But they can also hurt your relationship,
mm-mm.
You know, especially when you give them too much access and they begin to cross boundaries. They can
boundaries.
Begin to
wow.
encroach into your own personal life, you and your spouse.
So we should have boundaries.
Exactly. You have
even
to set.
Even for families. Even for people in your family should have boundaries.
Yes. It's very important because, human beings, we tend to sometimes cross boundaries when it's not checked. And intrusive, you know, some people become very intrusive. They want to be part of your own family. They want you to make decisions,
yes.
You know, consult them before you make decisions.
Let's
and things
that
like
minute.
That.
that's important. Sometimes a couple, we have to realize that when we are a couple, we have to be able to make decisions within ourselves.
Yes.
And if we need help, then we can invite the external,
Somebody else.
Person.
Exactly.
And that person could be from the family.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
So that's an important part, making decision as a team.
As a team.
Before expanding it to the family.
Yes, yes. Okay. You don't go consulting them and then bringing it to your spouse, and that's just not right.
Okay.
You and your partner or your spouse need to partner with each other. And you know, part of the ways some of the families hurt us is a mother who has always been a helicopter mom, always hovering around her children. It's very hard for them to allow their children to be independent of them.
To grow up.
They
seem to continue to see the child as,
yes,
as a little baby.
Exactly.
And even when the child gets married, it could be a man, it could be a woman.
Mm-hmm.
Gets married, sometimes the parent is still trying to mother the mother of an
exactly.
So we have to be careful,
yes,
about those things.
Yes.
So yeah, so the question is your family helping or hurting your relationship? It's a very important question that we ask in this particular discussion today.
Mm-hmm.
So I want us to continue by looking at the areas that what we can do as individuals to help the situation,
mm-hmm,
so that when family comes into, it's not that we have to let them go, but
yes,
we need our family.
Oh yes, definitely.
But where they are in our relationship is important. We have to make sure we understand the place of the family,
yes,
like you said, so that they won't be intrusive, they won't be crossing certain boundaries.
Mm-hmm.
When
mm-hmm
you allow your family to cross boundaries, you may be causing problems instead,
yes,
of helping.
Yes.
All right. So what about what do we do when we find ourselves dealing with family situations?
Well, I think one of the things that we have to do as a couple, you have to put your relationship with one another first.
Mm.
That is paramount. You know, you need to advocate for one another. The person that you're in relationship with, you need to stand up for him or her. You don't allow your mom or your dad to step on your spouse. You know, there are some moms that will just
or your siblings. Sometimes,
yes,
the siblings are the biggest problem.
Yeah, they will say, oh, because you know, before you were here,
yeah,
I was sort of thing,
you
know, and that's not right. And some mothers will say, oh, okay, this is my son's house, they will come and set camp. But the truth of the matter is that there's a new deputy in charge.
Is it really your son's house or is it this couple's house?
Exactly. You know,
yeah.
You don't come and, you know, just set camp and begin to dictate how things are supposed to be done and start looking at how things are not done right or how this is done too much.
They should be there when they are called upon to advise. Then
yes,
they can give the advice. They shouldn't be pushing their,
yes,
you know, ideas.
Yes, and people shouldn't change who they are because of other people's behavior.
Yes.
You know, sometimes the tendency is for us to either attack or begin to fight, and conflict will start, and you know, who needs that? And
mm-hmm,
so we ought to basically remain positive as much as we can and still stay kind.
And when you're relating,
you know,
to your family,
yes,
and the family of your spouse, it's important that you understand your place,
mm-hmm,
and their place.
Mm-hmm.
Right, right. So I want to kind of say a couple of things too about this. That is that you mentioned boundaries.
Mm-hmm.
Boundaries has to do with when you put a boundary, it's like a fence.
Yes.
And there is an entrance to that boundary.
Mm-hmm.
So a family, a couple should have something like an invisible door into their environment, into themselves.
Mm-hmm.
And that door should be known clearly. You should know who's coming and who's going out. What do I mean by that? again, just like what you said, when you guys have to deal with issues and stuff, work together in the house,
yes,
before going through the door,
yes,
to speak to other people.
Yes.
But when somebody is coming, let it come through that agreed upon door that you both are completely watching over, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that way it helps you to control
the outflow of
an inflow of people,
yeah,
into you.
Yes.
Right? Okay, so I want us to look at a couple of scriptures just to see that even the Bible lets us know that it's important that the couple know that they are the innermost part of that relationship,
yes,
bigger relationship.
Mm-hmm.
Right? You should not allow your family to be to hurt your relationship. Make them a blessing if you know how to deal with it. You don't reject your family, but you make them a blessing.
Yes.
So one of the scriptures I want us to look at is from Psalm 68 verse 6. It says that God sets solitaries in the family. In other words, God wants us to be in families.
Mm-hmm.
We don't get married and run away from our family.
No, that's not right.
We marry and we stay
miserable.
We help to grow that family. We help to make it even richer.
Yes.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
We benefit, like you just said, we benefit from having family. Some people, when they get married, they want to separate from the family.
That's another extreme.
Yeah.
That's not good.
That's bad. Yeah. If you're with somebody that they're always trying to separate you from your family, you have to be careful. Right? Another thing I want us to look at today is our Lord Jesus even talked about the importance of being unity of the couple,
yes,
first above the bigger family.
Mm-hmm.
That's the point I want to make right now from Mark chapter 10 verses 6 and 9. I'm going to read this one for us. It says, "But from the beginning of the creation, God made them male and female.
Mm-hmm.
For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife."
Yes.
"And the two shall become one flesh. So then they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man separate."
Yes.
Our Lord Jesus, although he was talking about divorce and stuff, but the same thing, family can be a problem if we don't understand our place.
Mm-hmm.
A couple, the Bible tells us, the Word of God tells us that God makes them one.
Yes.
That's one. And that makes them so closely knitted together.
Mm-hmm.
You know, tight together.
Mm-hmm.
That nothing should separate them.
Yes.
So you can be consulting your family in secret. It's almost like your leg is consulting, going somewhere, and your hand doesn't follow. Your hand, yes, stays at home.
Yes.
It doesn't make sense, right?
Mm-hmm.
So
it shouldn't be.
Before you consult your family, consult your spouse.
You have to be in accord.
We're going to talk about other things about, you know, spouse relationship when it comes to all manner of things. But in this particular one, you have to be in accord, and you have to make sure that you agree, like you just said.
Mm-hmm.
So the family is outside, you are inside. Talk to one another, plan together, consult family as a helping
resource
mm-hmm. for you,
mm-hmm.
helping resource. But don't use your family to fight one another.
Yes.
That's not going to help you in your relationship.
Yep, because sometimes people do that.
And they do that.
You know, it's not even the family interjecting, coming in uninvited. Sometimes we invite the family. We use our families to fight
one another. That is bad. So today our discussion is your family helping or hurting your relationship? I hope you know where we're coming from and what we believe. Your family should be helping and not hurting. But it's ultimately in your hand to decide how your family helps. Trust one another first, and mm-hmm. then invite the family. And you can control what happens. Don't let your family be overbearing upon your relationship.
Mm-hmm.
Be able to stand against your family if they try to intrude beyond the boundaries that you have set.
Yes.
All right. Let us pray. I want us to pray for people who may be struggling with this issue right now.
Yes.
We just want to pray for you. Maybe you've been going through something and you don't know how to handle it. family has been a big burden to you in your relationship. We just want to pray, Father, in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus, we thank you for allowing us to be able to come to your word and learn from your word. Today we thank you that you have told us you are the one that set us in family, so our family ought to be a blessing to us, not a source of a nightmare or hurting our relationship. We pray for the one right now, oh Father, who may be dealing with a family problem, maybe overbearing parents or siblings or what have you, hurting their relationship. Father, we pray that this couple can come together in unity right now and recognize that ultimately they need to build this thing together. They need to trust one another to have one mindset, so that when they deal with their families, the families may recognize that yes, they are working together. Mm-hmm. We pray blessings of peace in the family. Mm-hmm. We pray joy, oh Father.
Yes.
Those things that they may have been broken or messed up, Father, we pray that they be replenished in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
That peace will be returned. The ability to work together may return in the name of Jesus. Mm-hmm. And that you will know how to put your families where they should be in your relationship. Make them a resource and not a source of destruction. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Well, our time flies. So today we said that know that your family is a great part of your relationship. May don't let them be a nightmare. Make them a blessing by knowing how to relate to one another first before inviting your family into your relationship. All right. Okay. This is Nedu
and Uzioma Obed.
Until next time, remember, your blessing, your relationship should be a blessing and not a nightmare. All right.
Thank you for listening.
And yes, subscribe and share this with other people. Bye for now. God bless.
God bless.